research on Google searches. In certain words, Ugandans really care about, and he's not here. John Gastinos writes for the Washington Post, based in Kampala. He's an international.
Washington Times.
Washington Times. Thank you. Returning after a break. Honor Peter Ekomowitz.
That's exactly.
Corporate Affairs Director Nairobi Warriors, Esa Benyola.
In building the nation.
Building the nation. Our different white party people in Cuba. Harriet Anena. Sabobita with the Daily Monitor.
Actually, are people who build the nation.
Nicholas Sengova is a social and political commentator. And Angelo Izama. Team of course is not in the studio. It's been an intense week of activity. Much of the activity coming from neighboring Sudan, South Sudan, and the conflict between South Sudan and North Sudan over an oil-rich enclave called Hejrinj. What we're hearing now, of course, the Ugandan military announced yesterday that they will not stand by and watch if things get worse with a long history. But we're beginning to get information, Harriet should know better, that the South Sudanese troops have withdrawn from Hejrinj after a lot of condemnation from the United Nations Security Council and other international condemnation. Is it real or is it not real? This campaign to restore term limits in the Ugandan constitution, the campaign led by Western Youth MP Gerald Karuhanga, we'll be discussing that. And of course, we'll be discussing the Activists for Change, announced banned by the Attorney General Peter Nyombi, have changed name and now are called 4GC, for God and My Country. That's the best of the story is in the newspaper, and of course.
So we shall be banning the map of the country. I'm going to ban the country.
Let's start on the question of term limits. And I'll start with the owner who's been missing in action for some time. Honor,
who was involved in removing term limits?
I don't know if you're involved in removing term limits.
Term limits were removed. I was actively working for Exxanja.
I remember your signs during the campaign at that time.
But we are wearing Exxanja.
Honor, this is being brought as a private member's bill. You and Mugisha Muntu attempted once to raise a private member's bill that wanted to separate the executive from the legislature. Are term limits necessary? Let me put all these three questions to you so that you can answer at once. Are they necessary? Is it a feasible project of Gerald Karuhanga and his colleagues? And what will they have?
Well, the one about the motion that is almost anybody's guess, that in a parliament which is dominated by President Museveni, not really NRM as such, it's very unlikely that anything that he doesn't support and involves amending in the constitution would go through. But again, maybe we have seen across the world things happen that nobody expected. Maybe there's going to be such a time in the Ugandan parliament as well. But term limits in Uganda, let's be specific. I think the problem of term limits in Uganda, that's just a redundant idea. In case you have no term limits, but you don't change the current methods of work with the government, you'll only be having presidents whom you have to wait for 10 years to see them off, regardless of what they do. And I think that is the problem. I am not comfortable with having a president for 10 years as a consolation that 10 years and then he goes.
You could boot him after 5 years.
Which is the problem. I think the impeachment move was much more useful than term limits. If we gain the power to impeach a president because he's not doing the right thing, then you don't need term limits. At the same time, I think the people have the capacity to put term limits on leaders. The crisis in Africa is that regardless of term limits or term limits, the voters do not have the power or have not felt that they have the power to change leaders. So we're only saying, let's console ourselves, have a leader 5 years, then another 5 years, then that one goes, another one comes. But what is the effect of every 10 years? Is it going to be useful? As you mean specifically about Uganda, I think this country perhaps needs something more than term limits. It needs to see a certain transition of a president being defeated or a president dying in office. After 50 years, that will be a very useful lesson.
Or bowing out of power. When they're on.
No, I think bowing out of power is not... It needs to be defeated and then is replaced because people have decided that he is not good enough. At the same time, it would be nice also to have a president die in power. Mm. And then we see whether we are mature enough to handle that death.
Oh, really? Arup, what are your thoughts about this term limits debate?
I think since Ugandans don't have the power to elect the president out, restoring the term limits is one step towards ensuring probable smooth transition of power. And I think that this campaign will test the maturity or the lack of this ninth parliament. We've seen a lot of campaigns starting from the oil bribe allegations, then the impeachment, and now this. But you know, all of it comes with a lot of poke, a lot of air, and it dies out. So now we are seeing this, and 57 MPs have expressed their support for the term limits. Maybe looking at that, we can be able to judge whether the MPs are finally trying to do what they expected.
I've been told actually that one of the very, very high members, top list members of the formerly, not long ago, has walked to the promoter of this motion, Karhang, and said, where is the list I want to sign up? There's something we discussed here on this show about signature 163. I don't know, Nicholas, if you remember, 163 during the oil probe, the recording of parliament.
Is it the same individual?
They could be closely related. But, Nicholas, what's your position on this discussion? Is it a redundant discussion by Karhanga and his colleagues, or is it headed somewhere?
I will draw my arguments from the world of thieves in Kampala. There are two scenarios you always witness when you see thieves in Kampala. Yeah, when a thief is going to steal, he goes with a group of 10 or so people. So he snatches a handbag and people start shouting, "Oh, no, the other 9 people, there were 10 people, shield those who are running after him." And you know, they pretend, they say, "Oh, what are you running after? Oh, what has he done?" Meanwhile, the thief is taking off.
That's a pickpocket.
Thieves
are dealing in much more serious things.
Secondly, there is a scenario where somebody steals money, you know, maybe 2 million shillings in denominations of maybe 10,000, you know, and 10,000. So as people are closing in on him, he starts dropping some money. So they get distracted, pick money, and you know, he disappears. Mm. They even fight. At times they even fight.
And those who pick don't return it to the
region. And you know, so the other one goes safely. Now, the debates that you're seeing in Parliament about term limits, is it impeachment, and I am extremely skeptical. Because you see, what the MPs have learned about President Museveni is that if you threaten his power, you know, you put yourself on a strong in a strong position to negotiate with him, and one of the things that is good at giving out his money, you know, many of these MPs you hear, impeachment, this, that, we are going to bring them away, then they go to State House and it dies.
So you mean those guys are prospecting?
There's one, they are prospecting. Secondly, they are trying, you know, now the pressure that has come to President Museveni, whether it's real or not, from all these people, 4G, I don't know, it's called 4GC?
4GC now.
4GC, FOC, all these riots, all these, the Zach Neringiers, you know, because originally you had people like the Dr. Wesiges, and people say that one is not credible. They fought over this. I don't know, they fought over the other. That one is a political content. Now you have people like the Zach Neringiers coming in. Civil society is coming in. Now, what these people in Parliament are trying to do is to divert the attention of this, because they are saying that they are going to come with the fact, is it the the term limits debate in 2015. So what they want us to do is that we stop and say, oh, our parliamentarians have woken up, they are going to fight for this.
I thought that was a proposal from Salaman Eid's government.
Let me tell you something. All this, that's how they start. You know, it's, let me give you an example. When Real Madrid wants to buy a player, it starts as a rumor. They start by denying. They don't say we are. They start by denying. So we are not interested in Ronaldo. Those who are say next day when they, you know. So all these are the indicators. They are going to tell you that we shall start in 2015. Come 2015, they will ambush you and say, ah, the man has defeated us, you know. So that is what they are trying to do. But what I want to, no, Charles, let me tell you this. What Ugandans should know out there, those who are listening to me, is that stop having faith in this group of 330 people called parliamentarians. They are in that parliament to enrich themselves and be there. And you also have a responsibility towards your democratic future.
There is a parallel program by these NGOs which actually set a limit of September.
Exactly. That is why I'm saying when the civil society set the limit and they came, this is when the parliamentarians woke up. You know? So you have to be very careful with the motives of those parliamentarians. But it's time people in Uganda learned that you also, that each one of us, just like you look after your own home, you pay your electricity bill, you bring milk to the table for your children, you also have a responsibility in the way you are governed. You can't say, I hear people saying that parliamentarians let us down their time. That is their business. It is time that the people lead them.
Is the discussion necessary?
Necessary or the discussion? It was necessary a long time ago. I hear this, my brother Napito is saying, you see, no. I like what John, what's your name?
Gastinos.
John Gastinos.
Okay.
John Gastinos, what he said last week. He said that, you know, when you have term limits, when you have an open term, you are guaranteed of failure. You know, on the other hand, when you have term limits, there is a chance. Because now a person like President Museveni, honestly, we are talking about failure. Forget about all these other things, you know, but we found it's just nothing.
Angela, John, Chris, and Timothy, I'll come back to you after a short commercial break.
KFM Hot Seat.